Hello everybody, I'm Chef Jeff from Smith's. Okay, growing up, I love mac and cheese, this box stuff. In fact, it has to be this brand. My mom would always buy me the off-brand and I'd hate it. And so when I got older, I always vowed I'd always have this kind, which I always do. But we're gonna go and take a step up with that. We're gonna make our own mac and cheese in one pot. Let's get right to it. Okay, so in this pan here, I've got my milk and I've got chicken broth boiling. So one pot means that we're gonna cook our pasta in the same exact pot that we finish it all in. And so any pound of pasta will do. In fact, actually, before I do that, I need to season my liquids. And in here I have smoked paprika, garlic powder, pepper, and salt. I'm gonna get that in here. You could use regular paprika if you don't like the smoked. I just like the smoky flavor that it brings. So that's boiling, get that stirred in there. Back to the pasta. So it's boiling. Any kind of pasta will do, elbows, shells, any small pasta. I have cavatappi here. I'm just go ahead and throw that in there. And then give it a stir. And then you're just gonna cook it to the package directions, and that's about 9 minutes. And that's what I have going on over here. But before that, I wanna talk about something real quick. I'm gonna add to this an egg yolk. That sounds kind of strange, but what it does is it makes it so, not only will it add richness to it, but it will make it so that the sauce doesn't break in the end, because if you were to do it wrong, you'd have cheese on one side and a big oily mess, and you don't want that. And so the egg yolk is going to help to make that not happen. So what I'm going to do is get some Dijon mustard and mix it in with my egg yolk. But we don't want scrambled eggs, right? So what I'm going to do is temper it. I'm going to take some of that hot liquid, just a little bit, and pour into it, and then give it a stir. Just so I don't get those scrambled eggs. And I'm gonna do it one more time, just a little bit more hot liquid, just to get it to temperature without scrambling it. Do that one more time, and then I'm gonna add that to the cooking pasta and give that a stir. Back over to this pan. I've got all of that happening. My pasta's done. So now all I need to do is start adding cheese to it. We don't want the liquid to be boiling like a full boil when we start adding cheese. So I turn the heat down on it, and then I'm gonna start adding cheese. So what I have here is cream cheese. Get that in there that I've cut up into little pieces. Just makes it a little bit easier. And really, you're just stirring cheese until it melts, and then it's gonna be done. So we've got cream cheese there. Next, I'm gonna go Parmesan. And that's grated Parmesan. Just give that a stir. And then the next one I'm going to do is mozzarella. And then again, you could use any kind of cheese that you wanted. What I do suggest, though, is that you get cheese that you hand grate. Don't buy the stuff that's already grated, because it has like that powder cellulose or whatever on it that keeps it from sticking together. So we're gonna avoid having that. This is sharp cheddar that I'm gonna add last, because mac and cheese needs sharp cheddar. In fact, if you're gonna have any cheese in mac and cheese, I'd say it has to be sharp cheddar. Let's give that a stir. And then once it melts and comes together, that's it, guys. That's our one pot mac and cheese, and it's super good, it's super cheesy, and I've done it in just, you know, like what, 15 minutes total, just a few minutes here on the segment. But it's super easy, super good, brings back all those delicious memories of mac and cheese growing up, maybe a little bit better than the box, just a little bit. Okay, you guys, this is done. Let's get it in our little pot here. All the cheesy, melty, ooey, gooey yumminess. One pot mac and cheese. Of course, you can find all of these ingredients at your local Smith's. Let me pretty it up a little bit. Here's some Parmesan cheese. Here's some parsley, sorry. Ha, we did it. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you for shopping, and we'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.